Good evening, dear friends, and welcome to the service of Lessons and Carols for this blessed Christmas season 2022. The service of Lessons and Carols has a long and storied tradition here in the life of the Virginia Episcopal School, and we are glad that you are here and that we are here and that we can share together in this holy time. Friends, in that spirit, might we join standing together, and using your bulletin, might we sing our processional hymn, O Come, Emmanuel.
Amen. This Christmas season is our duty and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angel and to go with heart and mind to Bethlehem and see the things which have come to pass and the babe lying in the manger. Therefore, let us hear again from Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purpose of God from the first days of our sin until the glorious redemption brought to us by His Holy Child. And let us make this house of prayer glad with our carols of praise. But first, because this, of all things, we rejoice in Jesus' heart, let us pray to Him for the needs of the whole world and all His people, for peace upon the earth between the saved, for love and unity within the one church to build, for goodwill among all people. Particularly at this time, let's remember the poor, the cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick and them that mourn, the lonely and loved, the aged and the little children, and all who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love Him, or who by sin have grieved His heart of love. Lastly, let us remember all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater life. That multitude, which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom, in this Lord Jesus, we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven, and in the words that Christ Himself calls us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel. Therefore, the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from which he was taken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. was sent by God to the town of Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary then said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
shepherds go to the manger. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For see, I am bringing you good news of the great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was an angel with a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. The word of the Lord.
Yeah.
In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? We observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judea, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me the word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." Lord, the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. St. John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of the blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
humbly ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.